Hello everyone. In previous session, we have discussed regarding determination of coefficient of discharge for V notch, that is triangular notch. In this session, we will discuss the determination of CD, that is coefficient of discharge for rectangular notch. In procedure wise, procedure remain as it is for rectangular notch as well as a triangular notch, but only the difference is in place of V notch, we are placing rectangular notch. The aim of experiment is to determine the coefficient of discharge for rectangular notch. The apparatus required are centrifugal pump, tank, open channel, notch plate and hook gauge. Now, in this particular image, it is very clear that water is made flow through this particular horizontal channel and this particular rectangular notch. Here we have end view where we can clearly visualize the rectangular cross section of rectangular notch, and this L represent the width of the rectangular width of the rectangular notch, which is equal to, in our experiment, it is 12 centimeter, that is 0.12 meter. And B indicates the width of the channel, and H is head over the notch, and this is nothing but my crest level, and bottommost level of the channel and crest level is represented by P here. And coming to some important formulas required to the this particular experiment, that is Q theoretical discharge, which is equal to 2 by 3 square root of 2 g b h to the power 3 by 2, where h is head over the notch and g is the gravitational constant and b is nothing but width, or this particular width of the notch here I represented as L. Now coming to the actual discharge, that is Q actual, which is equal to volume divided by time, which is equal to A into H. A is nothing but cross section of collecting tank A, and H is nothing but rise of water in that particular collecting tank, and T is the time required to rise that particular water in the collecting tank. From these two, we can calculate the coefficient of discharge, which is equal to Q actual divided by Q theoretical, whatever we have done in the same as what we have done in the V notch experiment. Now, coming to the test apparatus, see it remain as it is of V notch. We will be having a sump tank and we will be having centrifugal pump and power supply for that. The water from sump will be pumped through this to this particular open channel through this particular gate valve, and this gate valve is mainly provided is to control the discharges, and water will be flowing through this open channel, and this at this particular end a notch plate is attached, and again we have hook gauge to calculate level of water in this particular open channel, that is to calculate head over the notch, and whatever water from this notch will be passed through the measuring tank, or also known as collecting tank, and the collecting tank is attached with a graduated scale which used to measure the height of water stored in this particular collecting tank. Here we have the image of the hook gauge where we can see the two knobs here. This is the first knob and this is the second knob, and once after setting the initial value, that is at a crest level, this particular knob should be tightened, and for next readings only the upper knob had to be operated. And here we have the view of the this particular enlarged view of the scale. Here we have two scales, that is one is main scale and one more is the vernier scale. In fact, we know that the least count of the main scale is nothing but 1 mm, but when we use this particular vernier scale, the least count of this vernier scale will be 0.1 mm. To get much accuracy, we will be using this particular vernier scale along with the main scale. Now, this is the view, the side view of this particular channel as well as the rectangular notch. This is nothing but width of the rectangular notch. In our laboratory, we have 12 centimeter rectangular notch width. Now, coming to the observation part, we have width of notch as 0.12 meter as discussed in the previous slide, and measuring tank area, which remain as it is of your V notch, that is area of the cross sectional area of this particular measuring tank, it is nothing but 0.25 meter square. Now, coming to the procedure part, first we need to place the notch, this particular rectangular notch, at one end of this particular channel, and we need to tighten all the screws. Along with that, once after that, switch on this particular centrifugal pump, and water is made to flow through this particular horizontal channel, and we need to wait up to when water is reached to the bottommost level of this particular rectangular notch, that is up to crest level. And once after that, we need to adjust this particular hook gauge to that particular water level, and we need to set the hook gauge reading, that is main scale and vernier scale, to one reading. Once after that, adjust the discharge. If you need three readings, we need to adjust the discharge in such a way that 33% for first trial, 60% to 70% for second trial, and 100% for the third trial. And if you need four readings, we can adjust same way, that is 25%, 50%, 75%, and 100%. Accordingly, that set the first reading, first 25%, and allow the water to come through this particular open this particular channel, and wait for 2 to 3 seconds, 2 to 3 minutes, to water to stabilize, and measure the first reading is your H1, that is the at a crest level. Measure the second reading, this is nothing but H2, and head over the notch is nothing but difference between H2 and H2 minus H1 gives the head over the notch. Coming to the calculation part, we need to tabulate all the values, that is initial reading. What I got, I have set it, is H1 is nothing but 10 mm, and H2 for first trial, for first discharge, what I got is 24.2 mm. Now, the difference between these is nothing but 14.2, and I have converted to meter, it will be 14.2 into 10 to the power minus 3. And using the formula and this H value, you can calculate Q theoretical, it works out to be 5.663 into 10 to the power minus 5 meter cube per second. And rise of water level in the tank, it will be 0.1 meter. Once after this water comes out from rectangular notch, I need to store the water in this particular collecting tank, and I need to see the time required to collect the water in this particular tank up to some certain height. Here I am going to consider 10 centimeter as a height. So for to rise the water for 10 centimeter, I need 57 seconds that I have recorded here for this particular discharge, and from that I can calculate Q actual by the formula A into H divided by T, where H equal to 0.1 meter, that is 10 centimeter, and answer works out to be 4.385 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter cube per second. From that, from Q actual and Q theoretical, I can calculate the CD value, that is coefficient of discharge, that is it works out to be 0.77. And likewise, I can calculate for all the trials, and average has to be tabulated here. And once after that, if I get all the values of Q actual as well as Q theoretical, I can draw a graph between log H. H is nothing but head over the notch, as well as Q actual, log H on X axis and log Q actual on Y axis. And if I tabulate all the values what I got here, I will get, I need to draw a line which is best fit line, and slope of this particular line should be 1.5, and I need to extend this particular line in such a way that it touches my y axis, and this particular value is nothing but log k. And we have the formula to calculate. Once we get log k, we can take anti-log and get the k value. From that you can calculate CD value as 2 by third CD b into square root of 2g. Here only CD is unknown. We know the k value, we know g value, we know the b value. We can calculate CD, and CD works out to be 0.81 for set of values. So from this, it is very clear that the value what we got from experimental, that is 0.77, and whatever we got by graphically, it is 0.1, it is matches, almost it matches, that is my inference.